Are you there? Can you hear me? I want to talk to you. Try to explain how everything got so fucked up. I'm not really sure how to do that when I'm just starting to figure it all out myself.
I just wanna be sweet. I just wanna be nice. I just wanna stay calm. I just wanna be gentle.
Kat, I have to go. If your goal is Tondelea Schwartz, you've achieved it.
I don't wanna be.
Tondelea Schwartz?
Who the hell is Tondelea Schwartz?
She's a hoe.
Oh, that's wonderful, Edward's two delinquents. Bye.
I wanna be a nice girl.
Just like every year, I prayed that this year was going to be different. You know, crawl out from under your shadow, get my mom off my back, and just stop being the freak that nobody wanted. I mean, it was pathetic. I was starting 11th grade, and I never even Frenched a guy.
I don't wanna pretend.
Guys like William Sellers didn't think that I was worth the pennies in his loafers, if he knew I existed. Why would he? Just look at him. All I wanted was to impress him, to get his attention.
I wanna be a nice girl.
Not exactly what I had in mind.
Made my pecker leap. Oh, don't be shy!
Good morning, Miss Darn.
Hi, Fred.
Excited about the new school year?
No.
Morning, Mr. Burton.
French toast and omelet.
Some cinnamon. You like a little medley?
Yeah.
How about a little champagne and orange juice?
Champagne would be good, yeah.
Cat! Cat, get in here!
Okay, I'm gonna die when I tell you what happened.
What happened?
I lost it.
To whom?
I went to this party in Lake Como with my mother, and there was this gorgeous Italian dude there, and he kept staring at me all night. And at the end of the party, everybody got so drunk and crazy that they started dancing in this fountain. So he drags me into the fountain, and we're dancing in the fountain, and he whispers in my ear that he wants to watch the sunrise with me down at the beach. So we go down to the beach, and he pulls down my pants. And then we made love.
What was it like?
It was amazing. Best part is, he's already in college. What's wrong with you?
Nothing. I hate my hair.
Why? I love your hair.
It just makes me feel like such a reject. I saw William Sellers this morning. My skirt flew up right in front of him.
So pathetic. You know what? You need to get over these high school guys. College is where the real men are.
Didn't it hurt?
No, I didn't even bleed. It's such a crock of shit what Mrs. Spielberg told us in biology. I'm really into sex now. Oh, wait. Princess, come here. Princess. Oh, look what I taught her. Come with me. He's the best dyke in town.
Ah. Delilah, put that back.
Why?
What if he sees you?
Good morning, sweeties.
Don't need no Oh, look.
Delilah.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Score. You're doing this with me.
No.
No choice in the matter.
Let's
You're doing
go.
This. You have no.
no
choice. Oh, my God, we're getting wasted. We give you $100?
Come on.
No choice.
Slug sucker.
Oh, look who it is. Little Miss Maidstone, fresh from another dreary summer of tennis and golf at the old beach club. Hey, guys. Hey, how are you? Can I walk with you? No. Fine. I don't want to be late. We don't want you to be late. I hate her so much.
Another year and I'm still here. Ladies, can we get a hand for the Hazelton Grand? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Anyone got a spliff?
Speaking of girls we love to hate, Heather Von Strum. Radiant, blonde, born with a silver stick up her ass. Talk about the perfect life. But you always said, no one's perfect, everyone's a closet freak.
How about another peekaboo of those panties? God, that girl's nasty. That's all I get. My little sister's more arousing than that.
Good morning, Miss Wilson. Good morning, Miss Kent.
William's going out with Heather?
Yeah.
I feel great about her.
Face it, she'd be no one if her dad had offed her mom.
Good morning, Miss Clark.
Good morning,
Miss Storm.
Good morning.
Good morning, Miss Milford.
Good morning, Doug.
Good morning, Miss
Delilah.
Milford.
Day.
I'll catch up with you later. Delilah, those stairs are for seniors.
Oh, look, Lady Mountbatten went here.
Delilah, come on. We're gonna be late.
Who do you think you are?
Delilah Milford ShopRite Harris?
I don't give a shit. And I'm telling.
No, don't. They're gonna give us 2 weeks detention.
So what are you going to do for me? I don't wanna be caught with that.
Okay.
Meet me in the second floor bathroom after recess.
Delilah.
Who can tell me what Pip gains through self-acceptance?
Are we still going shopping? I can't believe she said
it was so hot.
Kat, what do you think Pip learns?
Pip?
Learned a lot.
Could you please expand on that?
I learned a lot this summer.
About
sex.
Could you please expand on that?
Yeah, it was
Thank you, girls. That's enough.
Didn't hurt at all.
Grace, what do you think about Pip's journey?
That book was too bloody long. How do you expect me to get through something like that when I'm on holiday?
Eloise.
Pip's journey is about self-realization and acceptance. He wants to become part of a society he wasn't born into and abandons his code of morals to fit in. After great suffering and hardship, he learns that it is more important to be a morally just person.
She makes me sick.
I told you not to touch that stuff.
What'd you do, inhale the whole bottle?
Well, that's the way they do it in the movies.
Okay, Starface, come on. The show is over. So pathetic. What is that? Nose candy. Want some? High in calcium. Good for you, too.
Lean brain, she's gonna tell.
See if I care. Let the bitch squeal.
Okay. To qualify for the president's physical fitness test, you must be able to do 40 sit-ups in 1 minute. Begin.
One, two, three, four, five, six, eight,
ten,
12, 13, 20.
Ladies, Delilah Milford, Catherine Storm. Come with me, please.
But it was that fucking narc, Eloise.
My mom is gonna kill me.
It's gonna be okay. You just do what my dad always tells me to do. Deny, deny, deny.
Delilah, come with me. Catherine, you may go back to class. Excuse us, Miss Storm.
What's the disease of the week?
You think you have a tapeworm?
No.
You know how to get rid of a tapeworm, don't you?
I don't want to hear it.
You feed it until it gets as long as a garden hose, and then you pull it out your butt.
You do not.
Yeah, you do. Or sometimes it'll just come crawling right out of your mouth while you're sleeping like a snake. And
shut up! I don't want to hear it anymore!
Try and have a civilized deal.
Excuse me.
Oh, she just got her cooties all over my food.
Well, if he's done, so am I.
Where do you think you're going?
Delilah's.
Mm-mm. You're not going there. She's almost as screwed up as her degenerate parents. I wish you'd spend more time with girls like Eloise.
Mm. Eloise is a lesbo.
Catherine, I don't want to hear words like that coming out of your mouth.
What's a lesbo?
Two hoes doing it.
Catherine.
I am exiled.
So, where are you gonna go?
I have to start Riverdale next week. Riverdale? That's for Jewish people.
No, duh.
So where are you gonna go right now?
Get my head shrunk. Come over after school.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. What are you waiting for, dipstick?
I'm just waiting for my brother. Oh, hey, there he is. Hey, Toby! Hey, Toby! Aren't you gonna help me up?
All right, Nadia, come and eat. That's a 10.
Miss Major, excuse me, but somebody smells like poo.
I know, it's awful, but we don't know where it's coming from. What are you reading?
About Heather's dad?
No talking.
Heather,
and her father are always over at our house for dinner. What does it say?
Wow. It's about how your dinner guest gave his wife an overdose of sleeping pills to get rid of her.
That's enough. I've had it with all three of you.
But I didn't do anything.
All of you, out. You may continue with the 6 o'clock news off the school premises.
Put it on my account.
All right.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Yes, I'd like to see that.
What's that?
I have to smell this. God, everything's so expensive here.
My mom and I love this store.
I've never been here before.
Really?
Yeah.
We come in here all the time.
I haven't been here.
Of course.
Frosted Fantasy or Baby Nude?
What?
Which lipstick do you like better?
Oh, the beige one.
You still have a headband on.
No shit, Sherlock.
That is stealing.
So, don't you want one?
I can't. My mom would kill me.
Come on, Kat. We could be twins. Tweedledum and Tweedledee.
What if I got caught?
Kat.
Okay.
She's going to get in trouble.
Don't be ridiculous.
Excuse me?
Yes.
Just, you know you guys are going to get caught.
Blue handle.
This one.
I don't think I can reach it without a ladder. I'm sorry, but I can get one.
Never mind.
Let's go.
Did you get it?
Yes.
Excuse me, young ladies. Don't forget your package.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. I don't think it's so funny.
Oh, come on. That was bloody brilliant. Let's celebrate at my house over supper.
No.
I'm already late for my tutoring.
Well, Kat, what about you?
Okay.
That's a picture of me and my father on holiday in Bali.
Wish I had a dad like him.
Mwah. He's mine!
I believe he was mine.
You girl! Do you like what I'm
mad? You want the candy! He loves me!
I have a secret to tell you.
What?
I never stole anything before today. I did it to impress you.
Well, that's okay. I won't tell anyone.
Oh, you're the best, Stinkpot.
I thought you two went to sleep hours ago.
Good night, Mummy.
Good night, Grace. We love you.
Love you too.
Good night, Kat.
Good night, Mrs. Bailey.
It's lovely to have you here, Kat.
Thank you for letting me stay.
Night, Daddy.
Night, sweetie. Sleep well, girls. See you in the morning.
Good night, Kat.
Night, Grace.
Your hair looks absolutely wonderful like that.
You think?
It's beautiful.
Thanks to you and modern technology.
Hey, those legs look like they could use a little warming.
I'm never cold. It's my English blood.
What's got Hernicas in a knot?
Yeah, this place was robbed last night. Graduated. Oh, they got the good stuff. Harry, Winston, and Bulgari.
Take a couple from Tiffany. Stick that up your bum.
They took my...
Hey, you guys, let's go to my house
diamond
before
wedding
school.
Ring.
I mean... Hi.
Your cat, right?
The Tim Carrot one?
Do you remember me? From dancing school in Mr. Am's class in like the fifth grade?
Oh, man. Oh yeah!
I remember you having a mean foxtrot.
Really?
Except for when you stepped on
whatever.
My feet and stuff.
Oh. That was you?
Yeah. Are we going? William, come on,
sorry,
let's go.
Sorry, yeah. Let's go.
Great.
See ya.
Come on.
Bye.
I think I'll walk with Kat this morning.
Whatever.
You've got a mean foxtrot. Translation. Wants to shag you. Did you see the look on Heather's face?
She was just upset about her apartment being robbed. It doesn't mean anything.
No, it's obvious he likes you.
He totally couldn't like
you. Yes, he could.
Traitor.
What?
You were supposed to come over last night.
Oh my gosh, I totally forgot.
Yeah, right.
I swear.
I saw you talking to that bunch of rejects over on 80th Street.
So?
So you're better than that.
Come on, Kat, we're going to be late for school.
Who asked you? What, you'd rather hang out with her? She looks like she's six. The only reason those fucking imbeciles let her into our class is because of that accent. They think if you roll your R's, you have a higher IQ or something.
I'm leaving. Are you coming or not?
I'll just be a second. Fine. I really did forget.
No, whatever. So I was thinking we could do serendipity for your birthday.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? We always get frozen hot chocolate.
I just don't feel like celebrating this year.
Suit yourself. Call me, okay?
Okay.
Delivery for a cat storm?
Come here with that box.
Cat, somebody sent you flowers for your birthday. Ew, that's gross.
Who sent you those?
Love and Kisses, your best friend Delilah.
I always told you there was something wrong with that child.
Mom, leave me alone.
Is Eloise still a lesbo?
Get lost, Goober!
Hey, I know you're upset, but don't take it out on Pete.
I am not upset.
Fine. Have you heard from your father?
No.
Well, I knew if I didn't remind him, he'd forget.
He would not forget. Hi, Dad. Yeah, this is Kat. I just wanted to call you. Dad, aren't you forgetting something today? No, it is not Peter's birthday. It is my birthday.
Sort of bringing up Daddy.
Well, it's your fault. You should have reminded him. He's really busy.
Oh, he's busy.
Come on, Grace. Let's just get out of here.
I know where William and Toby are. We can go meet them.
Hey, not so fast.
But it's her birthday. You can't say no.
Yeah.
All right, fine. But don't be out too late.
Drink ever?
I don't like how it tastes.
No. You have to belt
What's
it.
What's wrong with the taste? It
tastes like wet dogs, how they smell.
Piss water.
Yeah, it's my girl.
You gotta wait. You gotta make a wish.
How could you? This is a fine, fine beverage.
Okay,
how could you
it's
not
absolutely disgusting.
You're 17 now. That's a real woman in
there. Yeah, and under you're close to death. All right.
You're so morbid.
I know, but no, I just never had a good birthday. You know, my last one, I kept begging my dad for
Here
one of those...
Here comes a sob story. Check this out. This is great.
I kept begging my dad for one of those red and blue waterproof watches.
Oh, it's... you mean a GMT Master?
Yeah. All right, shut the fuck up. Anyway, I kept asking him for it, and the day of my birthday, of course, who comes to the door but his fucking assistant Ronaldo with this fucking cheap thing, which I wore in the shower the next day, gets all steamed up. I can't tell time for
that like... Sounds tragic.
My heart bleeds for you, Toby. If you ever want to, like, talk to anybody about that, you know, you can call me.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that a lot.
Thanks.
Oh, thank you.
What do you want to do about this?
I'll just ditch it.
John, I'm going to
ditch it.
Okay, right, I'm going to go get a cab. Okay.
Piss or something.
Right, yeah, I'll go to the bathroom and
don't worry about it.
We'll take care of this on the way. And
this is pretty bogus.
Yeah.
My mom would kill me.
I
I can't believe we're doing this.
We could get arrested. Where is he?
Toby,
what? Toby,
please, Toby!
It's no sweat! What?
We're gonna get caught!
Oh, we're gonna get caught! Who? What the fuck?
Oh my god!
Are you good? Step in it! Fu Manchu is in hot pursuit!
Hey, where to?
Sir, we're going to 82nd Park.
Did you have a good time?
This was the best birthday I've ever had.
Good.
We met up with Eloise's brother. And this really, really cute guy, William, was there at this Chinese restaurant. Thank you so much for letting me go.
I should be going out with friends. As long as I know who you're going with and where you're going.
Night.
A turkey sat on a backyard fence and he sang a sad, sad song. Gobble, 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 gobble. I don't like Thanksgiving Day.
Thank you. That was wonderful. That was wonderful. Now I'm hoping everyone will go quietly back to their homerooms before leaving for the holiday. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
Absolutely gorgeous.
I want to eat one.
So what are you guys doing? I'm going to pop ping pong all over the place if I don't tell you.
What?
This is very hush-hush, you know.
What?
Pegasus, you could come to a Thanksgiving party.
Really? I didn't think Peggy even knew I existed.
I knew you'd be gagging at the thought of Peg's party, but I couldn't help it. I was excited. A part of me was in awe of Peg. Who wouldn't be? Perfect party Peg.
Hi, I'm so glad you made it.
Hello.
Hello. Hey, William.
Hey.
Come put your coats over here.
Perfect party Peg probably just puked to parade her pert little ass in that pricey dress.
Peg?
Yes?
Hello?
Hello, Peg.
Hello.
You had told me stories about these parties with older investment banker type guys, bringing drugs, looking for sex. But I had never believed you.
Kenny, huh? Are you holding out on us or not?
No, here we go. Oh, ready to go.
Hey, that's okay. I think I felt it.
Yeah,
this
is
expensive shit, you know? Would you?
Not my cup of tequila.
Oh, come on, you want to hang with the big boys, don't you?
Come on, Grace.
You only live once, right?
Okay.
Oh, I don't want any.
Come on, Stinkpot, your turn.
No thanks. What's your problem, anyways?
Why don't you leave her alone, Pam?
I didn't realize you were part of this conversation. Come on, you guys, I'm sick of being in here. Thank you.
What for?
For defending me just now?
No problem. Peck can be a real bitch when she's on a righteous act, you know?
Get your grimy paws off my car!
Next time, you fucking homo!
Hey!
Louis,
stop!
Come back here so I can slice off that little Jew prick!
Close the door and...
Would you...
Shut up! Put the fucking
sword down, man.
And get out!
That fag wore my cock
Whatever.
Big time.
Stop being so dramatic.
Yeah, dude, you need to chill out.
Oh, come on, man. It's the same old story. He fills us full of coke and he tries to score us a little wasp weenie. I mean, someone should put him back in line.
I'm so sick of this. We should all just get out.
You guys, she's serious. You should go.
Come on, babe. Toby's sorry, you know, he's just a prick when he's drunk.
I wanna talk to you.
Put your coats on, ladies. They're gonna be a while.
I ought to fucking go back there and fucking cut off his balls and Toby! Fucking little... Yo! What? Hey, no spot with a little lady?
Yeah, I doubt I'll see her anymore.
Man, fuck her and count nothing. We all know he did it, man. Who's he think it's
Look, cool? I was freaking out. He was right in front of me. All I wanted was to be alone with him. Yeah, right. Like I'd have had a clue what to do.
It's late. People are sleeping.
I don't fucking care! Oh! Ooh! No, who's got the biggest prick, New York? Ah! You, sir, you look awful tempted! Why don't you lay your lips on this?
I love it when your parents are out of town.
Where'd they go?
East Hampton with Eloise for Thanksgiving.
Well, why didn't you go with them?
It's too dysfunctional. My dad shuts himself up in his study all weekend, and my mom gets loaded waiting for him to come out, and no one ever gets around to cooking up a turkey, so Eloise and I wind up spending Thanksgiving at Paul's Pizza.
That sounds absolutely dreadful.
No, it's not exactly the perfect family holiday.
I don't think there is such a thing. At least I've never been to one.
Yeah, holidays never live up to what they're meant to be.
Yeah, they are a big sham. You know, I think it's just an excuse for, like, card companies to make another buck off the American public.
Hey. You watch what you say about card companies. My dad's stock is what... bought our house in Palm Beach.
I'm pooped.
Well, there's a bedroom down the hall if you want me to show you the rest of
I'm not going anywhere with you.
Why not? I mean, come on, it's nothing. And if you're pooped, I'll let you sleep.
No hands?
No hands. Come on.
Come on.
Catch, you'll be all right?
Yeah.
Were Peg and Heather really mad?
I don't care. I'd rather be with you anyway.
Why?
Because you're sweet.
You wouldn't say that if you knew me.
Wouldn't I? Well, how about I get to know you and we dance?
No.
Why not?
Because I'm not good anymore. It was a long time ago.
Please, I miss you stepping on my feet. Atta girl. Huh. Be serious.
Again?
Kat, everything's fine.
What's wrong with him? He's not normal.
He's fine.
Mommy, don't leave yet.
Mommy has to go to work in the morning.
Okay, there we go. It's all clean. Now you go back to bed.
What happens after you die?
You're not going to die for a very long, long time.
You're 9 years old, for Christ's sake. Would you stop worrying about it?
Kat, please, you're not helping the situation.
Me? He's the one who keeps us up every night with these anxieties.
I will die one day. And what?
Then we'd all get a good night's sleep.
Come on. Try and relax. And then maybe you can fall asleep.
Welcome to Melodrama.
Seems I'm the next victim on the robbery train.
And she was like, you're paying for dinner, right? I said, I'm going to the bathroom, and I left her there.
There better not be anything else
old
missing.
Kirk's. Hello.
Nice hat.
Thank you. I got it from your mama.
Hey, couldn't your housekeeper have taken your mom's ring?
No way. Gladys has been with us for 17 years. My dad thinks the maintenance man did it. I mean, he's the only one with keys.
Doormen have keys.
That's a good point.
Good show, Sherlock. Elementary, Watson.
But why would the doorman do it? We know him.
Do you? Do you know him? Secretly?
Be quiet.
Passionately?
Baby.
Erotically.
Hi.
Hey. Sorry, I didn't mean to bolt yesterday.
Oh, that's okay. So did everything work out with you and Heather?
We're not really gonna hang out anymore, but.
Oh.
I don't know, she didn't really like me anyway. She just liked how I looked on her arm.
I'm sorry.
Don't be.
Oh my God.
Hey, you guys gotta come in and hear this. You're not gonna believe it.
When the police arrived at 1 Beekman Place yesterday afternoon, they found the supermarket magnate, Mr. Gerald Milford III, age 73, still in his bedclothes, disheveled with visible vomit stains on his person. Quiet, everyone, or I'm not going to get through this.
Who is Gerald Milford?
He's Delilah's dad.
Oh, poor Delilah. Mr. Milford has been accused of kidnapping his secretary, Miss Jane Piley, 32, binding her arms and feet, shaving her head bald, and locking her in his bedroom closet for 5 days.
It's better than my dad ever did.
Over the past decade, Mr. Milford has been a reclusive heroin addict, squandering what is left of the Milford fortune.
Wow. Hey, how many Milfords does it take to screw a secretary?
4 and a dog.
Come on, Trusted Farms. Time to make the donuts. No. Come on.
No.
Come on, my little dope fiend. Come on. School time. Get up.
I can't believe you shaved her head.
I know. So I should have stuck up for you, but I knew what you'd say. That they were jealous. That no one's anyone until they've been on page 6.
Good morning. This is Catherine Storm's father. Oh, no, there's no problem. She's just very ill, and I think I'm going to keep her home today. Yeah, it's the stomach virus going around. All righty, be good. Bye-bye. All right, you got to be my mom. Come on. Pretty.
Yeah.
How come you don't ever drink or do drugs or any of that stuff?
Because I want to remember stuff.
Like what?
Like all of this.
I don't know. All I want to do is forget. All of this. Will you kiss me? Please?
on drugs.
No, it's true. Toby told me he drops acid all the time.
That doesn't sound like French to me, ladies.
What do I owe the pleasure of this visit?
Where's your Saint Laurent dress?
Which one?
That black strappy one.
Why?
William Sellers invited me to the Golden Silver. Bingo.
You can't wear that, Kat.
Why?
It's too mature.
No, it's not.
We'll go shopping and we'll find something more appropriate.
What, a dress for a 5-year-old so I can look like a total loser?
Upstairs in the office. Come on, you're breaking his day.
Daddy?
Hey, Beanie.
Hi.
Wonderful surprise. Are you all right? Is everything okay?
Oh, yeah. I can't eat another bite.
Well, you eat like a little bird, you know? If you don't, let me get you something else. What
Dad,
do you want?
Dad, it's not about the food. I need to talk to you.
Is it serious? Because if it's serious, I'll put on my serious face.
Dad, stop it. This boy that I like asked me to the Golden Silver Ball.
Really? That's great, Beanie.
And it costs $150.
Uh-huh.
And Mom said I should ask you.
Oh, she did. Great.
You know, things are a little tight around here lately. I don't have much cash. How about I give you 30 and I'll pay her back the rest later.
It's okay. Don't worry about it.
Okay, wait a minute. Here's 130.
She's gonna be mad.
Punchy, you got 20 bucks.
Sure thing, boss.
Now look, keep it in here so you don't lose it, all right?
Thanks, sir.
Oh, honey, I wish I had more to give you.
You'll be there for Christmas, right?
Early. Bell's on.
Thanks.
Bye.
Well, we have no choice. As incompetent IRS people say that I owe more back taxes.
For how long?
10 years.
10?
How else do you think I've been paying for your private school all these years?
I told you I would meet you downstairs.
I forgot. God, you look good.
Thanks.
You guys moving or something?
Redecorating.
Didn't you used to live on Park?
Yeah, before my parents got divorced. Mom, this is William.
How do you do? Nice to meet you, Mrs. Storm.
Hello.
We really should get going. Kat, may I speak to you? We're gonna be late.
He reeks of alcohol.
He does not.
I'm telling you, there's something odd about that boy.
Oh, please.
He was the same as a child, could never look you in the eyes to watch him at dancing school.
Why do you always have to say something negative about everyone?
It's not negative. I feel sorry for him. His father used to pick him up blind, drunk. It was a shame, really.
So you want me to stay at home like you and have no life?
I have a very fulfilling life.
Yeah, right.
Let's dance.
Do you want some coke?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
Come on, don't be a child. It's not a big deal, honey.
Hang on, William. Where are you going? The ballroom's downstairs.
No, we never go to a geriatric ward. Besides, Peg rented a suite.
Hi, you guys. I've been waiting for you all night. Hi, William.
Oh.
Come on.
Hi. I wish I was going somewhere warm. England is so freezing this time of year.
Try start. When I'm not skiing, I swear I'm an ice cube.
Hi, Kat. Hi, Grace.
So, Kat, where are you going?
Oh, I have to stay here. My mother doesn't like to go away over Christmas.
What a drag.
Yeah, I guess you'll have to keep William company.
You're not going anywhere?
No, I have to stay here and make up exams from last week.
Mm. That sounds like fun. I wish I could join you.
Oh, it's great fun. That's kind of why I got through it the first time, too.
Peg, look who's here.
Such a snooze fest downstairs.
I heard she dropped 20 grand on her dress.
No.
I made Kenny bring her just to check it out.
So I was wondering what the hell she was doing.
I can't believe she showed up.
I can't believe she has clothes on.
All right, we'll see you later. We'll give you woman a little piece of your mind.
Where's she going?
I will.
Good.
I didn't know you knew Kenny.
Everybody knows Kenny.
What are you doing?
You don't think I actually came over the company, do you?
I can't believe you.
I can't believe you go out with that bottom feeder.
You don't even know him.
I know he took my mom's necklace.
How do you know that?
I just do.
Oh, are you sure it wasn't one of your mom's boyfriends?
Thanks for having me. It was a real thrill. Nice hair.
Hey, what's in the bucket?
Kenny,
don't make,
shut up.
Mix left us a parting gift.
Calm down. Don't let the conniption fit.
Oh, I think I'm gonna be sick.
Oh, my stuff. Gotcha. She left the big cup. Who in the bucket?
Get rid of it.
Ooh, what?
Oh, Kenny, get rid of it.
Why me?
You just get rid of it.
It's disgusting. Where are we going?
My friend Rudolph's gone for the weekend, and all he said we could have his pad. Well, you guys are gonna love this place.
Who's Rudolph?
If a little boy likes a little girl, he should give the world to that little girl. Tell her that he loves her almost every day. Put his arms around her, chase the clouds away. If a little girl likes a little boy, she shouldn't get upset, she shouldn't get annoyed. If that little boy takes a little time waking up his heart, making up his mind.
What kind of name is Storm?
It's not my real name. My dad changed it.
What for?
Well, he got invited to the New York Athletic Club, and then he signed his name on the guest book, and they wouldn't let him in.
What was his name?
Myron Steinberg.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. It's pretty awful. You know, I never told anybody that before.
Well, your secret's safe with me. Catherine Steinberg.
What's the matter with you?
Hey! Huh. Another one bites the dust, huh? There we go.
Thanks.
Oh.
Where did you go?
I'm sorry, I got thirsty.
Mm-hmm. Looks like love, lover boy.
Looks like you're jealous.
I don't like her. Well, look at that. Oh, look! Princess fell down. Okay, that's it. No. That's enough for that. Let's go. Come on. Let's behave. Yeah, that's a good girl. Good. Hey, be cool. Be cool. Come on. Hey,
I
I'm only house sitting
mouth.
Here. That's it.
Be cool. Come on, I can't even feel anything.
Hey, come on.
Give her
don't
another counter. She's too fucking high.
No, I can't. I already gave her
I don't
two.
Give a fuck. Give her another one.
Come on, let's be cool. Don't break anything.
Yeah. What's up? We gotta get out of here. Rudolph is due back any minute. Get up.
I'm up.
Okay, let's go, sweetheart. Come on, sleeping beauty. Let's go. Let's get out of here. Wake her up. Come on, wake your girlfriend up.
You got a cigarette?
No, I don't have a cigarette. Get her up. Jesus Christ, no time for this.
Shut up.
Bullshit.
Come on, Kat, get up. She won't get up. Just let her sleep 10 more minutes.
Get her up.
She'll be all right.
Get her up. Come on.
Let her sleep. We got 5 minutes. No problem.
I don't think she's breathing.
Bullshit.
No, I don't. I can't find her pulse. Turn her over.
Turn her fucking over.
What the fuck are you talking about? I don't hear her heart beating. It's not beating. Does that mean she's dead?
How the fuck do I know? I'm not a doctor.
She's dead? Oh, no, God, that's not good. Rudolph is gonna be back here, and I can't have a dead girl here when he gets back.
We gotta
do something.
Should we call somebody?
Yeah, and say what? Sorry, officer, we killed her, but we promised not to do it again.
We gotta do something. It was an accident.
Yeah? You think anyone's gonna believe it was an accident?
Fuck, she's him. You're probably gonna have some stuff from her.
Oh, God, okay. Got her?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wait. Head first or feet first?
Head.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go. Yeah, come on.
Wait a second.
Come on.
Shh. I thought I heard her cough.
No, I didn't hear anything.
No, I'm serious. I swear to God. Listen.
Oh, Jesus.
love Christmas.
Did you tell them not to come?
You bet I did. After you stayed out all night gallivanting around town, ruining a one-of-a-kind gown that God only knows how am I going to pay for it?
I was at Grace's.
Don't make it worse by lying, Kat. I spoke to our mom, and I never gave you permission to use my Tiffany earrings.
I didn't touch those.
You're telling me you didn't borrow them?
Yes.
Why should I believe you, Kat?
I just wanted out of that nightmare. Go somewhere I thought there were better people. Somewhere I knew I was wanted.
Yes, dear.
Hi.
Excuse me for 1 second.
Get out of my way! Get out of my way!
Excuse me?
What do you want?
I'm just looking for William.
He's at the Y.
Come on, come on. Shoot, shoot! Yes! Yes!
Hey, come on, come on. Pass the ball.
Come on. Come on, over here.
That's a
trick. You get it. Cover, cover. Shot, pick it up.
Got the ball.
Oh. Okay, that's it. Let's go. Shower up, guys.
William.
Good game. Johnny, good shooting.
Hey.
What are you doing here?
I just came by to say hi.
Wait, who told you I was here?
I went by your house.
What the fuck did you do that for?
I just wanted to talk to you. My mom has been a nightmare all morning. She's convinced that I took her earrings. Pete's convinced he has...
In? Have to go.
Would you ring Delilah Milford for me, please?
Sorry, there's no one home.
Where's Fred?
He doesn't work here anymore.
Is he okay?
It's not that, it's just... he was let go. I'm sure he's fine.
Why?
There was a few robberies. The Milfords, the Logans.
But Fred would never steal anything.
Try telling that to management when only jewelry is missing and we're the only ones with the keys.
I'm telling you, I saw the watch with my own eyes.
You've finally gone off your rocker.
I'm serious. He's the one who's been stealing from everyone.
Look, I'll have to talk to you later.
Oh. Okay. Hey, guys! Wait, Grace? Hey, Peg. What is going on?
Did you really sleep with William?
Who told you that?
He told Peg that you slept with him after the gold and silver ball. And that you were bleeding all over the place.
That's not true.
He said there was so much blood it was dripping down the walls and he had to burn the sheets.
Well, why would he tell Peg that? He doesn't even like her.
Oh, you don't know. William and Peg are going out.
They named thee before me a canal to my
Nell.
Ear. A shudder comes o'er me. Why wert thou so dear? They knew not I knew thee, how knew thee too well. Long, long shall I rue thee too deeply to tell.
Catherine,
I'm so happy you decided to grace us with your presence.
I'm sorry.
In secret we met, in silence I grieve, that thy heart could forget, thy spirit deceive. If I should meet thee after long years, how should I greet thee with silence and tears?
What's wrong with you?
I don't want to go.
Is it that stupid boy again?
Mom, you don't understand.
No, I understand perfectly. Don't you see that boy doesn't deserve this kind of energy?
Mom, I already told you, you don't get it.
Get what?
My whole life, I felt like something's missing. Like I have this big black hole that I carry around with me. And then William comes along, and he likes me. And I feel happy. Like this was the way life was meant to be. And I'm not so empty and miserable. And I just don't want to go back to waking up every morning wishing I was somebody else.
Well, I'm sorry if you find this all so unacceptable.
What are you still doing home? I've had it with you. You'd better hurry yourself to school. One more misstep and they're throwing you out for good this time.
Okay.
Last night I took the strangest trip to a planet far away. The name is on my slip.
I can't believe you won't talk to me over some stupid thing William made up.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, you do. Blood dripping from the walls.
What rubbish! Do you really think I'd believe something like that?
Well, then why aren't you talking to me?
I'm talking to you right now, aren't I?
I guess so.
So, is it true about your dad?
What about him?
That he's Jewish?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, then that makes me feel like I don't really know you at all.
I felt sick. But I had to hand it to her. At least she had the guts to say what she really felt. Not like him, hiding behind his lies. He made my skin crawl. Thank you.
So this is what happens when your so-called friends desert you. I knew I should have cared, but all I cared about was finding you.
Hello, Kathy.
Hi, Miss Milford.
How are you, darling?
I'm fine.
Good.
Is Delilah home?
No, she is at the beach. She's become quite the little hostess, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's amazing how fast they grow, isn't it? Why, you've even got boobies. Au revoir, chérie.
Eloise didn't tell me you were coming this weekend.
I didn't really know.
She must have forgotten. I told her last week I was coming.
All right, then. I don't know what the big deal about the country is all of a sudden.
I feel a sudden urge to commune with nature.
Uh-huh. Toby just wants to go to Peg's party. She's building a big bonfire on the beach.
Weekend in the country to brighten one's spirits.
Still not buying it, Toby.
Why didn't Dad come?
He just had some work to finish up in the city.
Again?
He'll be out tomorrow.
Who's that?
Maybe it was Charles Manson's Squeaky Broom coming to get you.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I'll go check.
Hello!
Toby! Toby, what are you doing?
Providing an escape route.
Look who's here!
Daddy!
Hello,
oh, I didn't
darling.
Think you were coming till tomorrow.
Oh, I just couldn't stand to be away from my little girl.
Toby, stop bothering the girls.
How did you know I was back there?
Oh, I know. More than you think.
Good night, sweeties.
Good night.
I'm really not in the mood for this right now.
You didn't come here to hang out with me, did you?
No. I had to get out.
That's what I thought. Where are you going?
Like Milford's all fucked up and dancing with her top off over at Peg's party.
Come on, let's go.
To Peg's party? No.
Well, I'm going.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, that's strong.
I am a backdoor man tonight, baby. I will scoop that and lick it up.
Delilah, put your jacket back on. You're gonna freeze to death.
I didn't know you cared.
Hold on, man.
All right, I'll slide.
If you care so much, then where the hell were you when my father got arrested?
Well, I wanted to call you.
You wanted to call me? Fuck you. I've had so much shit going on in my life, and you couldn't even pick up the phone. What happened? Who are you?
I'm the same person.
Bullshit. You would have never left me like that. You don't know what it's been like. I've had nobody to talk to.
I know. I'm sorry.
Sorry doesn't mean anything to me anymore. I needed you, and you disappeared. Think about it, Kat. Who do I have to talk to?
I know. Who do I have? I'm so sorry. Sorry, Delilah. I really wish that I'd been there for you.
It's okay, I know. I can never stay mad at you. Just, you know, why did you? It just felt like you just all of a sudden didn't want to be my friend, you know? You just, I don't know, what happened?
It wasn't that, it's just, you know me too well.
So what's wrong with that?
Well, it was just easier not to be me for a while.
I'm freezing and Toby won't leave. Can't someone give us a ride?
I can go see if Kenny will give us a ride.
Well, where is he?
Music night in Rudolph at that bar, the last exit.
You mean that gay place in the woods?
Isn't it disgusting?
I'm so sick of you.
Are you staying with her?
Yeah.
I'll be back in a sec. Bye.
Bye.
So what if we were freaks? I'd rather be a freak any day than be one of them.
So, Kenny, we just about done here?
Yeah.
I'm heading back to the city now. Boy, you wanna assist me in carrying some stuff out to the car?
Okay. William? Look, it's chilly. Why don't you take my jacket?
No, I'll be okay.
Okay.
Freeze your ass off.
Sure, as soon as William gets back.
That's gonna take forever.
Okay.
Just find another ride.
That's good. Okay. See ya.
Figures.
Fuck.
Hey, wait up.
What do you want?
Hey, that wasn't what it looked like back there.
You can't be serious.
What did Kenny tell you?
Kenny didn't have to say anything. Do you really think I don't know what's been going on?
What are you talking about?
Come off it. You know damn well what I'm talking about. How your dad beats the crap out of your mom? How you steal from every apartment on Park Avenue?
Oh, okay, we can talk about this.
Talk about what? What a great guy you are? Gonna tell me some poor, pathetic story about your life? Hot so hard? Save it, okay? I know what you are.
Shut up.
Why? Maybe it's time you heard the truth. You're nothing but a middle-class common thief. Happy to get his dick sucked by any queer for a few bucks.
Shut up! Oh my God. Are you okay? Oh my God. It was an accident. I swear to God, are you okay?
An accident? What the fuck?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that.
You're fucking over. You're not getting out of this. I'm gonna press charges. You're fucking over.
Back to the beach, we're leaving.
We can't just leave her here.
All right, fine. You want to stay out here looking for her? Be my guest.
Delilah!
Come on!
Doing here? Where is everybody? Hey, have you seen Delilah?
No.
Well, you can't stay here.
I'll leave in a minute.
What's wrong with you? William, what the hell happened?
Go away. Kenny's outside. I gotta go.
She wants you to come home, Catherine.
Last seen alive, leaving the bar parking lot with William Sellers and a
acquaintance she had known for years. Sellers has been arrested in connection with the alleged murder. When asked for comment, a police spokesman would only say that evidence found at the scene appeared to link Mr. Sellers to...
I was so worried about you.
...residents in this sleepy community were stunned by the shock. Charges related to the murder of Delilah Milford.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Attempts to contact Mr. Sellers' parents for comment have been unsuccessful.
Tragedy, really. We're all very sad.
Do you think William Sellers had anything to do with this?
William couldn't hurt anyone.
Did you ever think anything like this could ever possibly happen?
Of course not. We live in good neighborhoods.
Delilah Milford lived in a good neighborhood.
But we weren't like Delilah. I mean, she was pretty reckless.
Does anybody have any idea what she might have been doing out in the woods of Southampton at 4 o'clock in the morning?
East Hampton.
Delilah was? I just can't listen to that.
I wasn't going to say anything like that.
Yeah, right.
I'm so sorry about Delilah. I feel terrible about what's happened. I know you always think Mommy's being critical and negative. But I don't mean it that way. I just get so concerned that I don't know what to say anymore. Or how to say it. Maybe I should have done things differently. Maybe I shouldn't have divorced your father. Or raised your kids in the city? I was just doing what I thought was best for you. But now it feels like I've done everything wrong.
No, you haven't.
Struggle so hard to fit in. And all the pain that you go through, it breaks my heart. Don't you know that I couldn't live with myself if anything ever happened to you or Pete?
I'm sorry.
So am I.
I love you.
you.